In this video we will talk about Tarsier monkey. Thank you for watching. Enjoy watching the video and please don't forget to subscribe to see all new video about animals adaptation. A tarsier is any of the about 13 species of small leaping primates. Family Tarsiidae that can only be found on certain islands in Southeast Asia, including the Philippines. Only 9-16 centimeters, 3.5-6 inches long, emitting a tail that is roughly twice that length, tarsiers are an intermediate form between lemurs and monkeys. In that they are nocturnal and have a keen sense of smell, tarsiers resemble lemurs. However, unlike lemurs, which have a damp and bald nose, they have a dry, hair-covered nose like monkeys, apes, and humans have. The structure of the eyes and placenta is likewise similariform. Description: the largest distinguishing characteristic of the tarsier, its big goggling eyes, are processed by an immense visual cortex in its little brain. The absence of the reflecting coating tapetum that the eyes of the majority of other nocturnal animals have presumably forced the need for the size of the eyes and visual cortex. The tarsier is also uncommon for possessing very long ankle bones tarsals, hence, the name tarsier, a short body, and a spherical, rotate-able head. The ears are big, membranous, and practically perpetually moving on the short face. Gray to dark brown in color, the fur is dense and silky. The tail has an underside that is scaly like a rat's, and in most species, it has an edge or terminal brush of hair. The only completely carnivorous primates are tarsiers, who feed on insects, lizards, and snakes. They rub their tails against the trunk of the tree as they cling upright to it. The tips of the digits, which are enlarged into disc-shaped adhesive pads, also aid in the grasp. Tarsiers use their considerably enlarged hind limbs to propel themselves from trunk to trunk as they traverse through the forest. Adults maintain vocal contact throughout the night while living in monogamous pairs and defending their territory from other pairs with incredibly high-pitched calls. These calls are duets, which are made by the male and female separately on the Celebes Sulawesi Island. After a gestation period of approximately 6 months, a single young animal is born in a pretty well-developed form, furred, and with its eyes open. Habitat: the southern Philippine Islands, Celebes Sulawesi, Borneo, Bangka, Belitung, the Natuna Islands, and Sumatra are all home to tarsiers. Throughout this region, species diverge to the point where some authorities attempted to group them into other genera. The western tarsier, Tarsius bangkanus, which lives in Indonesia and Malaysia, has enormous bulging eyes that make its head larger than it is long. It also has the longest tail. Although there is considerable disagreement regarding the taxonomy of tarsiers, most biologists acknowledge 13 or more species and divide the Tarsiidae family into three genera: Tarsius, Cephalopacus, and Carlito, which includes Philippine tarsiers. However, at least one taxonomy only accepts 7 species and includes Tarsius as the home to all of them. Tarsiers belong to a different infraorder called Tarsiforms despite being placed in the same suborder as monkeys, apes, and humans, infraorder Simiforms. 10 fantastic Tarsier facts. Find out more about these unique and historical primates that aren't monkeys. Little known nocturnal primates called tarsiers are about the size of a tennis ball. Wild tarsiers were once more common, but they are now only found in the Southeast Asian islands of Indonesia, Malaysia, the Philippines, and Brunei. 10 species and 4 subspecies of tarsiers, which are related to monkeys and apes, exist. To some extent, all tarsier species are threatened by extinction. They are worth a second glance since they have a glare unlike any other animal, extraordinarily long fingers, plushy fur, and the power to pounce and catch insects or even birds. The tarsier is a fantastic animal for the following reasons. The tarsiers have very large eyes. The largest eyes per unit of body size are seen in tarsiers. As big as the tarsier's entire brain, each eyeball measures about 16 millimeters in diameter. Because the eyeballs are so big, they cannot rotate. Instead, tarsiers, like owls, can turn their necks a complete 180 degrees in either direction. Instead of moving about to hunt, they employ this capacity to wait quietly for their prey to approach. The absence of the tapetum, A reflecting covering that is generally present on the eyes of other nocturnal animals is most likely responsible for the size of their eyes. Within an hour of birth, infants are ready to climb trees and are born with their eyes open. 2. They only consume carnivore food. The only completely carnivorous primate is the tarsier. They all share one thing in common, despite the fact that each species has a different diet, none of them consume any sort of plant materials. They eat insects, lizards, snakes, frogs, birds, bats, and other reptiles. They can even snag birds and bats out of the air because they are skilled ambush predators. They wait in silence for their prey to approach in the area. Old literature said that tarsiers consume food based on local lore. 3. Their appendages are lengthened. The incredibly lengthy tarsus bones in their foot give tarsiers their name. The tarsier's feet and hind legs are twice as long as its body, which is 4 to 6 inches long. They are an additional 8 to 9 inches longer because to their long, mostly hairless tail. Their third finger is as long as their entire upper arm, and their fingers are exceptionally lengthy to help them grasp tree branches. Their digit tips have the ability to grow into adhesive pads that resemble discs and help them hold objects. Tarsiers can jump and cling to vertical surfaces thanks to their unusual anatomical structure. They have a jump capacity of 40 times their body length. 4. They are ground-level residents usually. Tarsiers live between 3 and 6.5 feet above the ground. These creatures favor habitats covered in dark, dense foliage. They require a lot of tree cover, particularly when sleeping. They cling to a vertical tree branch or piece of bamboo and sleep there during the day. Insects and other prey have easier access to the rainforest because of the dense vegetation and the proximity to the forest floor. Additionally, it protects the delicate eyes from the sun. Both old growth and secondary woods, as well as low scrubby vegetation, support them. 5. Tarsiers come in three different types. Tarsiers come in three varieties: Philippine, Western, and Eastern. Sulawesi and the nearby islands are home to populations of Eastern tarsiers, Philippine tarsiers, which are only found in the Philippines and have completely bald tails and hairless feet, and Western tarsiers, which have tails with tufts at the end and are found in Brunei, Borneo, Indonesia, and Malaysia. The lowland species of the Philippine and Western tarsiers predominate, except for the pygmy form, which is only found over 1,600 feet in elevation. Eastern tarsiers are found in a variety of habitats and altitudes. When the pygmy form was not seen between 1921 and 2008, it was believed to have become extinct. 6. They are the oldest species of living primate in existence for at least 55 million years. Tarsiers are among the oldest primates on the planet. According to fossil evidence, they were once widely distributed throughout the world, including in North America and Europe. 4 tarsier fossils show a tiny creature weighing only a little over an ounce. These fossils' eye sockets imply that some of them were probably awake during the day. They do possess the gripping feet and lengthy hind limbs that modern tarsiers utilize to jump between branches. They perform poorly in captivity. Because of the unique requirements for habitat and prey, tarsiers are extremely difficult to breed in captivity, and only about 50% of those that are taken in survive. 5. Stressed tarsiers and those housed in cramped cages are more likely to consider suicide. Light, noise, humans in the natural habitat, and being touched are specific stresses. They will strike the cage's walls, the ground, or trees with their fragile heads. Their sole chance lies in habitat conservation. Compared to a natural animal's life expectancy of 24 years, the lifespan in captivity is only 2 to 12 years. 8. They sing duets. Complex duet sounds are made by pairs of tarsiers, most frequently heard before sunrise as they prepare for sleep. According to researchers, the tarsier couple is sharing information about their pair bond with other tarsiers nearby. The duets might be used to settle territorial disputes. These duets are of interest to researchers because the co-singing could shed light on the development of human language. Tarsiers have the ability to make ultrasonic cries, which may be used to alert neighbors to humans or potential predators like owls or snakes. 9. pygmy tarsiers were once thought to be extinct. 2008 saw the discovery of the first live population of pygmy tarsiers, Tarsius pumilus, since specimens were first obtained by collectors in 1930. They are the smallest living tarsiers, at only 3 to 4 inches long, not counting the tail, or about the size of a small mouse. They can move their ears and have thick, curling coats. Although pygmy tarsiers are not as loud as lowland tarsiers, researchers believe they may produce high-pitched sounds that are inaudible to humans. 10. They face extinction risk due to habitat fragmentation and fast habitat reduction. All tarsier species are at risk of extinction. Plantations of oil palm, coconut, and coffee have taken the place of the lush flora that tarsiers require to sustainably maintain their population levels. These creatures also face problems from human poaching for food and short-lived pets, as well as vulnerability to predation by feral cats and dogs. Southeast Asia needs concentrated and extensive conservation efforts to protect these species. One of the top 25 most endangered primates in the world is the tarsier from Sea Island. In addition to having had their natural habitat decimated, they are frequently consumed as a snack meal. Protect the tarsiers. Avoid going to roadside attractions or zoos that keep tarsiers in captivity. Support trustworthy environmental organizations like the Karela, Philippines-based Philippine Tarsier and Wildlife Sanctuary. Avoid anything produced with coconut or palm oil. Tarsier adaptations. There are a few distinctive characteristics that clearly strike out when you first look at a tarsier. It has big eyeballs to start. Despite having a little brain, it is actually incredibly powerful because of the quantity and amount of information that these enormous eyes can process. Amazingly, of all mammals, the tarsier has the widest eyes in relation to its size. Additionally, tarsiers have enormous hands and an extremely human-like appearance. Their lengthy fingers have cushioned tips that make it easier for them to hold onto tree limbs. The name, tarsier, is derived from the exceptionally long ankle or tarsal bones that are present in tarsiers. These men can even turn their heads 180 degrees to stare in the opposite way. As if that weren't enough, naturally, tarsiers don't have these characteristics only to look cool in front of their fellow primates. Similar to other animals, they have developed the particular physical features as adaptations to help them thrive in their surroundings. Since tarsiers are nocturnal, or nighttime creatures, their eyes are appropriate as an illustration. They can see better in the dark because they have bigger eyes. The tarsier's long tail aids in balance when it leaps from tree to tree, and its padded digits enable it to hold onto objects firmly in order to remain above ground. You should have figured by now that their major method of transportation is leaping, and those lengthy ankle bones, along with some powerful leg muscles that make up roughly 14 of the weight of the total tarsier, are useful for this as well. Besides that head turn, imagine being able to simply swivel your head to gaze behind you. This sneaky capacity to survey its surroundings. Invader and prey. Since they do not consume any plant matter, tarsiers are strict carnivores. Beetles, grasshoppers, cockroaches, butterflies, moths, and ants are some of their favorite foods. However, they also consume birds, lizards, and snakes. The tarsier can grab its prey in the air thanks to its quick leaping, and it has even been known to consume objects that are as big as it. Tarsiers do eat primarily from the air, but they sometimes catch prey on the ground and from leaves and branches. Lemur versus tarsier. Lemurs and tarsiers have similar nose structures. However, tarsiers have a dry nose and lack the reflecting substance that lemurs have behind their irises. The same characteristics apply to monkeys. Tarsier skulls have similar olfactory and visual characteristics to monkey skulls. A tarsier is it a lemur? With a tail that is roughly twice that length, tarsiers are an intermediate species between lemurs and monkeys in terms of size, only reaching lengths of 9-16 centimeters, 3.5-6 inches. Tarsiers are similar to lemurs in that they are nocturnal and have a keen sense of smell. Do tarsiers share a genus with lemurs? These oddballs are actually our distant cousins, it turns out. Despite having some similarities to strepsirrhines, the lemurs and larises, tarsiers actually belong to the anthropoid family, which includes humans and other primates and apes. What characteristics make tarsiers special? The tarsier is also remarkable in that it has a short body, a circular head that can swivel 180 degrees, and very long ankle bones tarsals, thus the name tarsier. The ears are large, membranous, and move almost constantly. The face is short. The thick, silky fur ranges in color from gray to dark brown. What kind of defenses do tarsiers have? Answer and justification: predators of tarsiers include small carnivores, owls and other raptors, as well as humans. They spend the day hiding out in tree holes or burrows for protection. Because it is more difficult to notice these tiny organisms at night, they benefit from their nocturnal lifestyle by avoiding predators. Why are tarsiers' eyes immobile? Of all mammals, tarsiers have the largest eyes in proportion to their size. The tarsier's whole brain fits inside each eyeball, which measures about 16 millimeters in diameter. They can't rotate the eyes because they are so big. As with owls, tarsiers can instead turn their necks a full 180 degrees in each direction. How are tarsiers able to see at night? In order to adapt to the nighttime existence, tarsiers develop their wide-eyed look. The majority of nocturnal creatures, however, lack big, fixed eyes. Instead, they have a reflective layer called the tapetum lucidum behind their retinas. Light enters the eye, travels through the retina, and is partially absorbed there. Are tarsiers two-tongued creatures? Anatomical design. In tarsiers, lemuriform primates, and some other mammals, the sublingua, sometimes known as the under tongue, is a secondary tongue that is situated underneath the original tongue. There are no taste receptors or salivary glands in this structure. Tarsiers can be timid. Currently, the majority of tarsier species are listed as being threatened, endangered, or severely endangered. Hunting, agricultural pollutants, habitat loss and fragmentation, and human disturbance are all threats. Tarsiers are extremely shy creatures who want to avoid interacting with people. Thank you for watching my video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like to this video.